So when getting a mortgage, oftentimes you have the option to do what's called buying a point. So in order to buy a point, the benefit of doing this is that your APR will come down. It won't come down by a full percentage, it'll come down by a quarter of a percent, so 0.25%. But there's a trade-off there, right? So you can get a lower interest rate, however, you have to pay usually 1% of the mortgage amount. So in this example, we're going to suppose we have a $200,000 mortgage. And if we do not buy the point, it's going to be at 4% APR, compounded monthly. That's fairly standard. So the question is, should we buy the point? Well, that depends on a number of things, but we're going to simplify this a little bit. So first of all, let's look at how much the point costs. So the point costs us 1% of the 200,000. So 1% of that, or 0.01 times 200,000. So it's going to cost us $2,000 at the beginning. So this is basically a fee that we pay the bank in order to get a lower interest rate. That money, that $2,000, does not lower your mortgage amount. Your mortgage is still for $200,000. So this is just an upfront fee that you have to pay in order to get the lower interest rate. So that would be the next piece of this. So should we buy a point? Well, okay, we have to pay $2,000 up front, but we know that with compound interest, a lower interest rate is very, very helpful. So if you were to run through and find the payment, so let's look at without the point, right, without buying the point, and then with the point. Without the point, we have that APR of 4%. If we buy the point, that means we paid this fee to get a lower APR. So our APR is going to be 3.75%, a quarter of a percentage less. If you run this through, and let's assume, for example, we're doing a 30-year mortgage. So that's pretty standard, 30-year fixed rate mortgage. If you run this through, we can figure out, okay, what is our monthly payment? And you might imagine this is part of the reason we do this trade-off is that, okay, yes, we have to pay more upfront, but now that our APR is lower, our interest rate is lower, then our payment is probably going to be lower. So if we kind of work through all of those pieces, in the first case, without buying the point, so at 4% APR, our monthly payment is $954.83. Right, we can just use the TVM solver to help us figure that out. And if we lower the point, lower the APR, our payment is $926.23. So right, it only goes down by about $30 in a single month. But if we think about the lifetime of this, right, total payment, our total amount paid, well, we could take that monthly payment and say, okay, we're doing that every month over the course of 30 years. So we've got 954.83 times 12 times 30. So we're doing this, right, many times over. And we can say, well, how much would I have paid in that situation? And we would get $343,738.80. Okay, well, let's see how that compares on the other side. So if we do total paid the same way, so take our monthly payment, 926.23, multiply by 12 and by 30, right, every month for 30 years, then we're going to get $333,442.80. Now, this is clearly a lot less than this. And the only thing we want to make sure that we incorporate, right, is the fee that we also had to pay at the beginning. So in total, this is if we stayed the entire length of time, the entire 30 years, which isn't always the case. So that's something worth considering as well. But we're comparing essentially this number, the 343,000 and some extra, with not quite this number because we've got to incorporate the fee. So with the fee, right, it's 335,000, right? Just add 2,000 to this, 442.80. So we're really comparing those two numbers. But even in that sense, it looks like buying the point is still worth it. We're still saving money overall in the long run. Remember, these monthly payments you can find, you can just use the TVM solver. The only thing that differs between the two of them is the APR, right? The interest, the I value for those. These total paid, right? It just depends on how long the loan is. I was supposing it was a 30-year mortgage. Of course, we could look at different term mortgages that would just change this number. But the process of buying a point works this same way every time. 1% of your mortgage amount, and it's going to lower your APR by 0.25%. In general, if you're going to stay the whole time, usually buying the point is worth it in most cases.